Good morning, everyone. My name is Sandu Cibataru. I'm currently working at the Petroponi Institute of Macromolecular Chemistry, Iași, Romania. And I'm glad to participate to this conference organized in my home country. Today, I will speak about our work regarding pegylated phenothiazine derivatives, synthesis, and antitumor activity. I will start with a short introduction, and after that, I will speak about synthesis of the pegylated phenothiazine, their structural characterization, their water solubility and stability, photophysical behavior, ability to form aggregates, and also about in vitro and in vivo biocompatibility and antitumor activity tests. The final step was this, I will discuss a possible mechanism of their action. Phenothiazine is a fused three-cycle system which have a band shape named butterfly geometry, and due to its electron donating properties, this compound is used for synthesis of derivatives used in optoelectronics, such as dye system solar cells, organic light emitted diodes, field effect transistors, and also to obtain derivatives for drug formulations. And due to its versatile properties, the phenothiazine presented good activities as antitumor agents, analgesics, neuroleptics, and bactericides. Polyethylene glycol is a biocompatible FDA-approved synthetic polymer, which is used for new drugs formulations. This polymer have a high water solubility and the ability to self-assembly. And the aim of our work was to combine these two compounds to obtain the pegylated phenothiazine derivatives. We obtained three of them by coupling phenothiazine core to the polyethylene glycol through different functional groups as ether, ester, and amide. Here you can see those three compounds we synthesized and their water solutions. The synthesis pathway was done in three different methods. First compound PP was obtained by direct alkylation of the tosylated polyethylene glycol to the phenothiazine core. Compound PPN was obtained from a activated ester of the phenothiazine, and the PPO compound was obtained by direct esterification of the phenothiazine acids with the hydroxypolyethylene glycol using coping agents. The successful synthesis of this compound was confirmed by two spectroscopic methods. The FTIR spectroscopy represents vibrational bands characteristic to the functional groups from these compounds. You can see this vibrational band for PPN characteristic to amide group, and in the third absorption spectra, the vibrational band for PPO compound characteristic to ester group. Also, they were confirmed by NMR spectroscopy. Here you can see the proton signals from each compound in the right ratio of their integrals, and for compound PPN is very easy to observe this signal, which is characteristic to amide proton. Due to the fact that polyethylene glycol have a high solubility in water, we decided to test the solubility of our compounds in water and other solvents. As you can see, they are perfectly soluble in each solvent except hexane, where the solubility is lower due to the high non-polarity of this solvent. Also, we observed that depending on solvent, we have a difference in color of these compounds, and also a difference in emissive in fluorescence. This can be translated as a solvatochromic effect. As these compounds were designed for biological application, we decided to investigate their water stability, and we recorded NMR spectra of this compound in water, in deuterite water, during 7 days. As you can see, no modification were occurred in the NMR spectra, which means that this compound are stable. Taking into account the electron donating properties of the phenothiazine core, we investigated the photophysical behavior of these compounds. So in the absorption spectra of this compound, comparing with the phenothiazine, we observe two different absorption bands. But the interesting fact is that the absorption bands of phenothiazine derivatives is butachromically shifted, which can be attributed to a aggregation effect. This hypothesis were confirmed by fluorescence spectra, which we made on different on solutions of different concentrations, and the best fluorescence we obtained for solutions of 0.1 millimolar. The aggregation effect was confirmed by DLS technique. We did this in time during 60 days, and as you can see, the smallest aggregates we obtained for compound PPO, but the most stable aggregates were obtained for compound PPN. We also determined the critical micellar concentration using UVV spectroscopy, and this concentration is around 0.7 and 0.9 micromolar. The spherical shape of this aggregate were confirmed using techniques as atomic force microscopy and confocal conic microscopy. We used also polarized optical microscopy and scanning electron microscopy to observe this aggregate, but these two techniques was done on a compound dispersed in a polymer matrix. The biocompatibility of this compound was also investigated, and we did this on fibroblast. As you can see, all three compounds are biocompatible up to 0.1 millimolar. Also, we investigated their cytotoxicity on HeLa cells, and we observed that at 0.1 millimolar, where they were biocompatible, we have a cytotoxic effect for compound PP and PPO. That's why we tested them on a large spectra of cancer cells, and the best results are obtained for compound PPO on hepatic and breast cancer cells. These two compounds was also tested on colon cancer cell lines characteristic to mice, and the result was much better than comparing to human cancer cells, 10 times better specifically. Here you can see in this graph you can see the median inhibition concentration of these two compounds on each cell lines, and also its selectivity index for each cell line. Our result we compared with other results published in literature for doxorubicin and 5-fluorouracil, and in some cases our result is better than those from literature. That's why we moved forward and tested this compound, these two compound in vivo on mice. First, we determined the median lethal dose of these two compound and phenothiazine as a positive control. After that, we administrated this compound to mice in a dose lower than LD50 during 10 days by intraperitoneal administration. After 10 days, we observed that tumor approximately totally inhibited by these two compound, comparing to a negative control PBS. The tumor inhibition was 92%, and comparing this result with other results done on the same cell line, we observed that our results are much better. So taking into account these results, we decided to propose a possible mechanism of action. First, we did some investigation for compound PPO and PP, and from these results, we concluded that the antitumor effect is provided by this compound and phenothiazine acid, which occur in cells after enzymatic hydrolysis. We did some investigation using single crystal X-ray diffraction, FTIR, and NMR spectroscopy, and we observed that this compound can bond magnesium or zinc ion, which are two iron metals characteristic to a farnesyl transferase metal enzyme, which have an important role in cell signaling pathway. We also we thought that this compound can inhibit this metalloenzyme. We also tested its cytotoxic effect on HeLa cells, and we observed that this compound, the phenothiazine acid, have a good cytotoxicity and a good selectivity index on a wide range of concentrations. Another interesting fact, we observed that PPO compound in a cell medium forms some aggregates around the cells. We put this compound in the same medium but without cells and observed the same thing. This wasn't observed for compound PP. These results made us to conclude that the possible mechanism of action of this compound are our compound PPO in a biological medium forms aggregates which are safely delivered to the cells, where they enter in the cell by endocytosis. There, these compounds are hydrolyzed by esterase or others other enzymes to phenothiazine acid, which will bond magnesium or zinc ions, and this way inhibiting the farnesyl transferase. As a conclusion, a series of three pegylated phenothiazine derivatives were synthesized and characterized structurally, morphologically, and photophysically. They also can make some aggregates. The main part was the in vitro test, which demonstrated the biocompatibility and cytotoxic effect of two compounds. In vivo test on mice demonstrated that two compounds inhibit almost totally the growth of tumor cells. And the investigation of this possible antitumor mechanism showed that the anticancer activity could be the result of synergic effect of polyethylene glycol and phenothiazine, with the major contribution of the acid result by enzymatic hydrolysis. We'll have some perspective in this direction, and these are functionalization of the pegylated derivatives in order to improve the antitumor activity, to the preparation of formulations with synergic properties, and also synthesis of phenothiazine-based polymers with improved solubility. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Chibodaro, for your interesting presentation. Questions to the reporter? Any questions? I have a question. Will you tell, please, how you determine and with which accuracy determination of critical concentration?
For critical concentration, I used UVB spectroscopy. I recorded the UVB spectra for compounds at different concentration, and when the absorption band didn't show some differences, we combined these two axis, and the point of intersection is the critical micellar concentration of the compound.
Okay, good. And which accuracy approximately? This is 10%, 20%, 50% accuracy. Just estimation.
Accuracy of this technique?
Yes.
I think 8%. I found this technique in literature, so I applied this.
You
it's
found
not my invention.
You found this technique and applied for determination.
For my compounds, yes.
Okay, good. Good. Some other questions? And one more question. Have you prepared or are you going to prepare project, for example, Horizon 2020, Horizon Europe? Program project, because this is a very, very important and very actual activity, anti-tumor activity.
I think so, maybe. Mm-hmm. to prepare a project.
Okay, we can think
in
about such possibility.